name is Harlan. She living the life just like a movie star. Oh.
Hey everybody, this is Evie from Twin Dragons 310, and it is just two more days until Halloween 2011. I wanted to do something a little special for everybody. A while ago, I got this. This is the first Scott Pilgrim comic book. And a while ago, I was bored. On occasion, I do get bored. And I decided to take... I wanted to write Scott a... Yes, this Scott right here. A fan letter. And hold on, I'm working with the mirror. And as you can see, right here... You can't see it really well, but if you look it up in the book... You can clearly see Scott Pilgrim's home address to where he and Wallace live. And here's the next scene of Ramona and him talking. So I thought, hey, I should just, you know, just for the hell of it, to see what happens, I should write Scott Pilgrim a fan letter. And I sure did. And I got this in the mail about a week and a half later. I've covered up my address because I don't want people bothering me, but as you can see, as actual Canadian stamp and stamps. Those are real stamps. And it says right here, let's see, right here, Scott Pilgrim, 27 Albert Avenue, Toronto, Ontario, Canada, M6H2R5. And I guess I signed my name incorrectly because it says surgeon. And a surgeon, that's me, I guess. And I very carefully opened it when I did, and here's the letter inside, and it says, "Dear Anna, thank you for the sick letter. It must have been tough to track down my address down. I appreciate the effort. We tried to keep my street name secret to avoid too much fan/hate mail. Who could hate Scott Pilgrim? That's not right. Life is the same old up here in Ontario. Our band is getting some gigs. I still play bass, and." The weather is too cold. Ramona was happy to hear you admire her so much. Normally, I'm the one being admired. Haha. Then the next paragraph is, these are answering questions that I asked him. I'm a big fan of X-Men, and I know that he is too, from the jacket that he wears right here. You can't see it here. Let's see if I can find it. I know some people are probably like, read the rest of the letter! But I wanted to get a reference down for people that don't know that Scott is an X-Men fan. Here it is. You can see here in the Goodwill with him and Knives, you can see the X on his shoulder right there. That's the X-Men symbol, and you can also see it in the movie, which is really great. See if I can find another shot. Oh, here we are. In the library. Hold on. Sorry, it's the mirror. You can see Knives and him walking down the stairs to check out books that she needs, and you can see the X-Men symbol right there. Then, who's that chick? Oh my gosh, it's the chick of my dreams! Anyway, back to the letter. The second half, like I said before, is where he answered questions that I had asked him in my letter I sent to him. And what's neat about this is in the word favorite, he adds a U. I think that's pretty neat. Maybe this guy... I don't know, whatever. I think my favorite X-Men mutant is Rogue. She reminds me of Ramona. That was my phone. Don't you think? The movies were pretty good, too. Maybe my movie was a bit better, though. And no, we didn't make any money off fighting Ramona's seven evil exes, but the movie producers paid us for meals during movie shootings. I'll take anything I can get as an unemployed amateur musician. Good luck learning the bass. I learned on my own, but it's easier with a teacher. Hope you're well in Indiana. We are Sex Bomb! Uh-oh. That's one of my... Hold on. That's one of my alarms. Oh, Bleach will be on soon, but that's okay. Bleach can wait. I know there are reruns. And then it says Scott Pilgrim right here at the bottom. And what's a little strange about this letter is that my friend Corey Aiden, as some may know him, is a like diehard Scott Pilgrim fan. He actually told me about it before the movie came out, and he said that Scott wasn't self-taught, that I was being trolled. That was the first time I heard that expression. Oh, real quick. Ramona butt! Okay, back to subject. that I was being trolled by somebody. But, you know, there's got to be somebody at that address, and they get fan art all the time, so why not write back to the fans? And the signature right here, Scott Pilgrim, looks exact to the one in the movie, which is based off of the book. Let me see if I can find the signature part where he signs for his CDs that he bought off of Amazon.ca. Oh, there's the scene where he's ordering it. Talking. Here we go. Here it is at the very bottom. Scott Pilgrim. And then there's the comparison there. Scott Pilgrim. I did look up the location of Scott Pilgrim's house that you see. It is an actual house, you know, the one that he says he grew up in. If you didn't know that, that's where it is. Let's see, where is it? Oh, I went back too far. Hold on. Here, I'll hold the book so you can see it. Launchpad McQuack. Run, he's too good for you. Here we go. This house right here is actually based off of a real house that I think Mr. O'Malley lived in or something. And I looked that up, and then tonight I looked up the actual location of this address. And I found it, and it was pretty cool looking. It was just a little regular dinky brick house. Well, I shouldn't say dinky, it was cool. Oh my gosh! No! Scott's handwriting. That's part of my N. It's okay, I'll live. I have most of the address. Anyway. And I'll post it in the credits so everyone can see it in case they haven't already looked it up on Google Maps. Thanks, Google Maps, for helping us stalk each other. It's so much fun. And I really want to go up to Toronto, Canada someday and check out all the locations that I can, go to Pizza Pizza and get some pizza, and find Scott's supposed house that he grew up in. It's actually not, if you saw the movie, it's actually not directly across the street from him and Wallace's apartment. But man, that neighborhood is beautiful. I really want to go there someday. Let's put that back in there and see. Yep, and that's all for now. If you would like me to do a review on the book or anything, want me to talk more about Scott Pilgrim, just put that in the comments. All right, and thanks a lot for watching. This is Evie from Twin Dragons 310, signing off.